Come on, Blue. Come on, Blue. Go, Blue, Blue. Go. Go. Come on, Blue. Go, Blue. Yes. So, oh, hi, guys. How are you guys doing? I've been trying to come up with some ways just to keep myself occupied over the past couple of months. Sometimes, you know, at home all day, it gets a little dull. So, what have you guys been up to over the past couple of months to keep yourself occupied? Here's one thing that I've been doing.
I've been designing a bunch of stuff in Minecraft, like this lodge up in the mountains, where if you're into skiing, you can come up and ski in the wintertime, and then come in and stay in this nice, cozy lodge and sit down by the fire and relax in the wintertime. Or maybe you'd like an island getaway, like your own private island mansion, just to yourself. Where you have your own yacht, you have your nice cool deck that wraps around the whole building, you have your own swimming pool, and it's all on your own private island, all to yourself. Or maybe you'd like an entire village built on an island, and this is what I've been working on for the past couple of weeks. This is build an entire village on an island with a big kind of fortress in the middle there, some docks on the sides. All different kinds of houses and workshops for people to live and work in, places for people to keep their animals, gardens for them to grow, a park for people to enjoy, all contained on this one little island. And it's been really fun kind of designing what people would need if they live in a village like this, what kind of day-to-day needs would they need provided for them on this island. And I also made a hotel that was built into the side of a hill. And if you look, you can see all the little windows and doors that come out of the hill that are hotel rooms. And the whole inside of the hill is carved out and filled in with these hotel rooms. But from the outside, it still looks very natural. And this got me thinking about a famous architect named Frank Lloyd Wright. An architect is a person who designs buildings. And Frank Lloyd Wright was an architect who tried to come up with new ways to design buildings so that they looked like they really belonged in the environment that they were built in. So that's who we're going to talk about today. We're going to talk about Frank Lloyd Wright. We're going to talk about architecture. And later on, you'll get a chance to design your own architectural designs as a part of our at-home project. Frank Lloyd Wright was America's foremost architect. An architect is a person who designs buildings. Frank Lloyd Wright is well known for the uncluttered, clean-cut, strong and natural architecture that he designed, especially homes. Wright believed that the interior and the exterior of a home should go together as well as suiting the people who live in the house. He developed the concept of organic architecture, which is architecture that blends in with the natural settings in which the building is built. Wright said that a building should be a grace to the landscape that it was built upon, and not a disgrace. His most famous buildings are the Guggenheim Museum in New York City and the Falling Water House in Pennsylvania. But he designed hundreds and hundreds of different buildings throughout his long career.
Thank you. Now here's your chance to do your very own architecture project inspired by the work of Frank Lloyd Wright. Let's take a look at the instructions and the supplies that we're going to need.
This is an architectural design project in which you'll be able to design your very own building that fits well into the environment or setting that it's built in. First, decide what type of building you want to design. Will it be a house, a skyscraper, a museum, a church, or some other type of building? Then, decide what type of environment or setting it will be built in. A city, or the country, or a neighborhood, or the seaside, or the mountains. Then decide what the building will need based on how you think the building will be used. How big will it need to be? What types of features should the building have? What does it need in order to fit in well with its surroundings? Then you can make your building design in a number of ways. The most basic way is to make a drawing that shows what the building would look like. It can be a simple line drawing on the outside, or a floor plan style drawing that shows all the rooms laid out from above, like these. Or you can make both types of drawings. Another option is to design your building in Minecraft if you have access to that game and are familiar with how to build in the game's creative mode. Thirdly, you can use Legos or other three-dimensional building materials to construct your building if you have your own set of Legos or any other materials at your disposal to build with. The supplies you'll need for this project are white drawing paper, some pencils, both drawing pencils and colored pencils, a ruler, and an eraser. If you'd like to do this project using Minecraft, you'll need access to the game Minecraft. If you'd like to do this project using Legos, you'll need to have a set of Legos. And if you'd like to do this project using any other three-dimensional building materials, you'll have to gather those together if you wish to build this as a three-dimensional project build. Here's a demonstration as to how you might go about building this project if you choose to build it using the game Minecraft. You're going to open up a creative mode world if you have it already, or if not, start a new world in creative mode. Then you're going to go scouting around the landscape looking for the place where you want your building to be built. And at this point, you've already decided what type of building you want to build. Now you just have to decide a good place to put it inside of your Minecraft map. And I've decided to build here in this flat area located in between all these kind of rocky cliff walls overlooking a nice river. I figured that that's a nice place to build a house. And the first thing you want to do is kind of scout out the area, decide where the building is actually going to be built, and if you need to do any cleaning up of the area, getting rid of things that are going to get in the way of your building, go ahead and do that first. Then you're going to lay the foundation of your building. The foundation is kind of the basic outline of what the building, what kind of shape the building is going to have. And usually use stone in this case, or a lot of people often use cement. I'm using stone here. I think it's going to look nice. And I'm going to make the outline of my house using this foundation stone first. And as I go around, I'll make the four sides of the foundation and decide where is the door going to be. I think the door will be back here. So I'm actually going to dig out a little bit more and make kind of like a little sidewalk area where it can lead up to a door. And that'll kind of blend in with the foundation that I've already constructed. And then I'm going to kind of even out the foundation walls so that they're even all the way around the outline of the building. Now I have my foundation laid out. I'm going to start adding the floor, the basic floorboards of the house, and that really fills in that shape of the outline that I did with the foundation. So I'm putting in the floor right here. And if you decide you want to change kind of the shape of the foundation, you could still do that. That's actually what I did here. I started to change the shape of the foundation just so that it matches the other side and it's symmetrical like that. So we have our foundation, we have our floor, and now we could start building our walls. So we'll take some pieces of wood and make these upright beams. We'll go around, and then we could fill in between the upright beams. We'll fill in with some more wood to make the walls. Here we have to make some decisions about where we want our windows to be. And here's our door frame going up. We're making the shape of the door. We'll have a double door here. So we'll fill in the walls, and we'll also decide where the windows are going to be. So maybe I want a big, huge window to be here looking out over the river. So I'll add that to the design, making room for the window, making the shape of the window with the wall blocks here. Okay, just finishing off the walls with another piece of wood beam. Once everything is nice and filled in and all the windows are set in the design of the walls, fill in everything. And we'll pull back and see how it's coming along now. Now we can start working on the roof and add some roof pieces and having it kind of connect to the dirt wall in the back there. I'll add some window panes inside of the window with glass, and then we can move on to the next part and add some lights, and then we'll add an outside porch that wraps all the way around the house, some stairs so you can get up to the entrance of the house. And then up here on top I added some more grass that comes from the cliff so that it looks like it's really kind of blending from the cliff into the building, and add a little more roof tiles, and actually going to add some trees up here, so give it an extra natural look. So I'll plant a couple of trees up here on the roof just to make it blend in even more with the natural settings. Hey, here's our almost completed house. You'll see some vines coming down from the wraparound stone porch. Back here, you'll see the little sidewalk that leads to the door in the back of the house. And if you go inside, we'll see some inside walls and furniture. We look out the window, we see that nice, lovely view outside our window every morning. So if you want to keep on building, you can keep on building. I built a little staircase that goes down stairs where there'll be some other rooms that maybe I'll build those at some other point. But as for now, I think our little organic house in the cliffside is good for now. And I think it really blends in well with the environment that it was built upon. Maybe if you're not into Minecraft and you enjoy building with these instead, Legos, if you want to try designing and building your building using Legos, Legos are a great option for creative design. So if you have a set of Legos at home, you can give it a try. Maybe if you have kind of like a base sheet, like this green base sheet here, you can use it as kind of the foundation and then construct your building on top of it. Decide what kind of building you want to build first and what it could look like. And then you construct your building out of Legos.
So I hope you had a great time creatively designing and building these buildings. And as always, if you have pictures or screenshots of your buildings, I'd love to see them. So upload them to our art classroom page and we'll see what amazing buildings you made today. So until next time, I hope you have a great time designing and building, and I'll see you again sometime soon. Bye now.